This week on Jersey Matters, people are reporting a brain fog after catching COVID-19. We'll talk with a neurologist at Rutgers studying the effect of the virus on the brain. We go back to ground zero of the New Jersey tornadoes to check on recovery efforts. Weatherman Nick Pittman explains why we're seeing more tornadoes, and a gripping story of a veteran who almost took his own life. Hello and welcome to Jersey Matters. I'm Larry Menti. A landmark research study on the effects of COVID-19 on the brain is just getting started in New Jersey at Rutgers University, and they are looking for volunteers. I spoke with the man running the study, Dr. William Hu, neurologist at Rutgers Robert Wood Johnson Medical School. Thank you so much for agreeing to do the interview. This is a fascinating topic. I have heard from people personally who have had COVID-19 and have reported memory loss afterwards. And this seems like it's happening to a lot of people, doctor. I'm sure that's why you're doing the study.
Yeah, we began a post-COVID recovery clinic at Rutgers soon after the first wave hit. And what we're realizing is that about half the people who recover from COVID have some sort of cognitive complaints, which people sometimes refer to as brain fog. But once we start breaking down what people mean, some people complain of just kind of a mental sluggishness or fatigue, like when you're having a fever, you just don't feel well, or people can just take a long time to do what they used to do. And then finally, there are some people who have frank forgetfulness. So they'll forget what they did yesterday, what their spouse have talked about. And when we started looking into some of the folks deeper, with a brain MRI, we start to see some changes that seem to reflect what some of these participants of our studies are complaining about. So now we're trying to really get to the cause as to what's going on, what's leading to these changes in the brain.
Is age predeterminant? Are you finding that it's every age group or is it older people?
It's really every age group. There may be a slight predisposition if you're older, but we've seen people in their 20s, we've seen people in their 30s, and there's every so slight preponderance of people who are a little older, but people who are a little older are also more likely to come to the doctors. So I'm not sure that's really a reliable predictor for the cognitive impairment following COVID.
Are there other people studying this right now?
I think there are starting to be a number of groups of scientists and physicians studying this. Many are primarily focused on the type of memory issues people have in terms of slow down thinking, slow down processing, forgetfulness. Very few groups are trying to get at the underlying cause of this. Because I'm a neurologist, we are able to access people's spinal fluid, which is in direct contact with the brain, to better understand what's happening in the brain. And with the assistance of our volunteers, I think we're getting closer every day to what is happening in the brain that's causing these memory and issues and brain fog symptoms.
And I guess your hope would be if you understand the cause, you can come up with a cure or at least a treatment.
Yeah, that's our goal. And I think that a lot of what's happened with COVID has to do with inflammation. And that's one of the big areas that we're studying. One potential treatment, if you will, is really prevention. When somebody is sick with acute COVID, is there something we can do differently to reduce the risks of coming out on the other end with brain fog symptoms? And similarly, what we're also doing is following people 6 months, 12 months out from the initial symptoms to see whether some of these symptoms persist or whether they actually resolve on their own. And if there's anything we can do in the meantime to help them improve.
No, it's funny. I was just going to ask you how long it lasts. So that's you don't have a definitive answer on that yet?
Yeah, we don't have a definitive answer. Certainly, I think this disease is still very new, even though it's been around for almost 2 years now. What we do know is that some people improve within 3 to 6 months, while others, the symptoms persist well past a year.
3 to 6 months is still a long time for brain fog, but not everybody gets it, right?
not everybody gets it. And I think that's what we want to understand in terms of why some people get it and why others don't. One of the early guesses that we had was that the more severe the disease you had, the more severe COVID you had, the more likely that you would develop the brain fog symptoms. That has turned out not to be true. And it seems that people can have very mild COVID or sometimes even asymptomatic COVID, but then weeks and months later, they may experience the onset of brain fog symptoms along with other physical symptoms. And again, this disease is just so new that we're learning a lot about it from all the people who are willing to participate in studies.
Well, congratulations. I know you applied for and got a grant so you could do this study. And it's wonderful that this is happening at Rutgers and in New Jersey. In many ways, the state's been in the forefront of research, and Rutgers has been too, into the effects of COVID-19. Are you looking for people still to take part in the study?
Yes, we are. We are especially looking for people who had very mild COVID, who recovered and then have developed cognitive symptoms. And I think if folks are interested in contacting us, we have an email that you can reach out to, and it's memory411, like the number 411, memory411 at rutgers.edu.
Okay, and we will definitely put that up and try to repeat it on our website as well. Hopefully people will come to you for this study, and we can figure out what's going on, and most importantly, how you can relieve people of these symptoms. Thank you so much, Doctor. I really appreciate your time. And if you don't mind, would like to check back in with you when you're near the end of this study.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
Thank you. Neurologist William Hu at the Rutgers Robert Wood Johnson Medical School. By the way, Dr. Hu told me one of the things they're also studying is the possible connection between COVID-19 and early onset Alzheimer's or dementia. Still to come on Jersey Matters, a New Jersey advocate asking for your help in fighting the obesity epidemic. That's next.